do my thing. I want to get into it, man, you know. Like a sex machine, man. Moving, doing it, you know. Can I count it off? 1, 2, 3, 4. Get up.
What up, though? Guess who picked that song? The sex machine himself, John Z. Matthews.
You know it.
Now you're probably wondering to yourself, Jude, why you having John pick fucking songs to open up with? You should pick your own fucking weird songs to open up with. Well, today is John Z. Matthews' birthday. Let's give yourself a round of applause for fucking being born.
Woohoo.
You ain't got no claps or no shit like that? Yeah, there it is.
I made it.
His dad was a priest. His mom was a nun. They fucking stopped doing it, and he came in her. And 9 months later, little Johnny came out. And 52 years later, fucking here's John. Corniest man in hip-hop.
Not 52, but right.
Fucking happy birthday to you, John.
Thank you very much.
Happy fucking birthday. Yep, yes, indeedy. The show appreciates you. We've said this before. I used to want you to die when you first came on here, but
I remember
you
that.
Yes, every day I would just be like, please let him get hit by something big driving. But somehow you are able to not get hit by a car and fucking add to the show and have become indisposable for the All Out show. So I'd like to wish you a happy birthday and
thank you
for all of the things that you've done for the show.
Oh, I appreciate that.
888-742-3345. 888-742-3345. John has fucking banged hookers. Drank his own fucking underwear water in front of one of his favorite bands.
Yeah, from the Black Keys.
Yep.
I remember that.
Underwear water from the Black Keys.
He was very disappointed. I think he actually said that. Well, he just said he was disgusted. Something.
Yeah, he wasn't disappointed. Like, I don't think he was emotionally invested enough in you to be disappointed. You know what I mean?
Right.
Got your nuts kicked. You did get paid for that one.
I did.
You fought Chris. You've been you've hopped on many a hand grenades for this show. So
yeah, that whole fight episode rearranged my face. I speak differently now. My nose is different.
That's Jason Ellis's fault. Let's be real.
I know.
Jason Ellis fucking taking his whole day out on you. Fucking taking his week out on your face.
Come on, it's your little blood, mate. Ow,
come on, Mike. You look
hurt.
Like a sailor now. You look like you work on the docks now because of fucking Alice rearranging your goddamn nose. Yeah, you got any big plans for fucking for your birthday?
You know, things are a little tight, so, you know, I'll ride the bike home.
Yeah.
Maybe have a little of that whiskey that we have floating around.
And, yeah.
Check in with the ladies that I live with, and that's about it.
There you go. I know it's this has been a tough year for celebrations all around, but whatever it is, I hope you enjoy yourself.
Thank you.
Have a good time. You on Venmo?
Indeed I am.
What is it? Just John C. Matthews or some shit?
Oh, I don't know. I can look it up.
Bro.
Yeah, I hear you. What is it? It's one of those. There's probably a number involved. These things get complicated, don't they? Got the Cash App working here, too.
I'm trying. Well, I got money in Venmo. I was going to send you some birthday money. That you can fucking
looks like it's John Dash Matthews Dash 64.
The year he was born.
See, again, you're really trying to drive home that myth. I'm not 64.
No, that was the year you were born.
Oh, right, yeah, exactly.
John Dash Matthews Dash 64.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all gonna put an at in front of that shit or anything, or is it just?
Yeah, I think so. Probably.
Well, I don't know how this shit goes.
You'll know it because I'm out there talking to some reporter, man on the street.
Oh yeah, there it is. Yep. Right. Let's send John a birthday present. All right, there you go. Boom.
Very thoughtful. I appreciate it.
B-Day. Happy fucking birthday. Thank you, man. Thank you.
I appreciate that. I can tell when you're sincere, so I appreciate that.
When am I not sincere? It's kind of my deal. There you go. There you go. Happy fucking birthday to you, Johnny. Now you can go buy yourself something fucking... Go buy some top shelf fucking liquor and fucking get faded with the webcam girls.
See? Yeah, there are a couple new ones.
Yeah,
in the back. Hoo boy.
You said the black chick was throwing you the vibe. Is she still?
Or
was that just a one-off deal?
I mean, it's hard to say. I'm not really working that angle because that sounds like a real problem in the making there.
You don't want to shit where you eat.
I do not want to blow up my spot. Hey, she wants to talk to me all the time, so we'll see.
There you go. Fair enough. Does anybody want to wish John a happy birthday? Nobody? Uh-huh. Are you fucking kidding me? Not one call?
No, that's not true at all.
No, not one fucking call. No one called for your birthday. That is fucked up. I see. Come on, y'all.
I know. See, where's the love? Where's the love?
Just playing. I can't see the computer at all. I'm in my living room. 888-742-3345 is John's birthday. You'll fucking shout him out. What up, though?
Adrian Nashville.
Hey, Adrian.
What up, though? Happy birthday, John. What up, Jude?
What up, man?
Thank you, man.
Yeah, just want to give John a shout out, man. I know we always give him a lot of shit, man, but hey, you holding it down, man. Much respect to you.
Yes, he
is. One thing I want to add, though, man, I didn't know you were a Virgo. I'm a Virgo. That kind of leaves me kind of in a fucked up predicament, man.
I didn't know
we're the same fucking time, man, but hey. Hold it down, bro. Much love to you, Jude.
Thanks, bro. And happy birthday to you, John.
Thank you.
Sorry that you guys are Virgos together.
Yeah.
There's some cool Virgos out there.
Wasn't sure if Adrian was really on my side, but maybe.
It was kind of, he didn't like all the way shit on you. You know what I mean? Like, he just didn't want to be the same as you.
Right.
He appreciated you, but he wanted to be different.
He wants a little distance.
Yeah. He likes you in theory.
He likes people to turn it off.
888-742-3345. It is our producer, John Matthews' fucking birthday. Corniest man in all of rap.
All right, there's Sasha in Syracuse.
Sasha.
Johnny boy, happy birthday.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I just want to let you know, I sent you some news in your DM to add to your spank bank so you can, you know, jerk off tonight on your roommate's couch.
Right.
Shit. She sent you some nudes.
Oh, did you really?
Yeah,
I really did. Wow. I'll send you more if you want. I can send you a couple.
Interesting. Is that through Instagram?
It sure is.
Whoa. Okay.
Look at that.
Hey.
All right. Well, happy birthday.
Thank you, Sasha. Things are looking up. Come on.
Look at that. You got some titties for your birthday.
Not bad.
And he will jerk off to you.
I
trust.
That's guaranteed.
Trust.
So.
He's got a problem.
She's that to look forward to.
Yeah. Huh. He's jerked off to episodes of Cops before.
Hey. things get pretty hot.
Those domestic violence calls, man. John can't help himself. 888-742-3345. Who we got?
Faith in Cedar Rapids.
Faith.
Yes, I would like to wish John a happy, happy birthday. Nice. You guys always give him so much shit on the show, and I don't think it's fair sometimes. But happy birthday, John.
Oh, thank you. But at other times, I deserve it. What?
Well,
sometimes you ask for it.
I see.
Sometimes you ask for it.
Sometimes you're a smug asshole, John. Sometimes.
My smug asshole.
Yeah. And so are you, Rude. But, you know, that's why I love your show.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Appreciate you.
When am I smug? I mean, I can smell it on you, but when am I smug? When was the last time you said, boy, that's a real smug thing to say? Or perhaps this is right now.
anytime there's anything that like goes against your news source, you're like, whatever. Okay, sure, whatever.
Bullshit.
Not what I heard. Not what I heard. 888-742-3345. We're wishing John a happy birthday.
Got C-Buck in the Bay Area.
C-Buck.
Hey, what up, Jude? What up, though?
What up, though, man?
Hey, happy birthday.
I said, go ahead and holler at Johnny. I'm going to stay out of this one. Go.
Oh, for sure, for sure. Hey, what up, John? What's up, man?
Hey, C-Buck.
Hey, man, I hope you get you some real good WAP on your birthday, man. Don't mess around. Don't be no punk.
You know, that list is a little short these days, but...
Man, you got chicks all around you. You got chicks in your crib, and you can't get no WAP. Come on, bro.
Yeah, but I live with them. That would be such a horrible mistake, but all right. Hey.
I got faith in you, John. Don't be a loser.
Thanks, C-Bark.
All right, man. Happy birthday, bro.
Are any of them going to move out soon?
Oh, they're bound to. I think one lady's on a 6-month. So, yeah. Hey.
Get her.
We'll see.
Get her. Be like, hey, it's my birthday. You want to drink with me?
Come on into my room here.
You want to give me some pity sex for my birthday?
There's one lady in the back, though. She is banging. I just saw her for the first time the other day. She's moved in. I probably shouldn't say this on the air. They probably already think I'm kind of creepy.
None of the chicks listen to this show. What are you talking about? 888-742-3345. It's John's birthday. We're wishing him a happy 53rd birthday. Something like that. Mm-hmm.
I don't even know how old I am anymore. I just stopped paying attention. I'm in my 40s somewhere.
Yeah.
Somewhere.
Yeah, it is.
That neighborhood.
Okay.
There's Haley in Dalton, Georgia.
Haley.
Hey, what's up, guys?
What's up, what's up? You got John.
I just wanted to wish you a happy birthday and let you know that I'm on my way home from work. So glad to finally be off. As soon as I get home, I'm going to take a shot and toast it to you. Hope you have a good one.
Wow.
Look at that.
Man.
Damn.
Look at that. Yeah, thank you.
It's like titty Christmas.
Well, you know, I'll take it. Thank you, Haley. I appreciate it.
It's going to be a messy phone. It's going to be a fucking messy phone. Oh, buddy. Who's next?
Let's see. Jacob in Houston.
Jacob.
Yo, happy birthday, John. I just want to let you know I listen to you guys every day when I'm on my way home. And, nice. Bro, you made me laugh, bro. It's so funny.
See, look, see.
Good. Oh, thank you. That's
not
a positive.
Everybody thinks that you're a total piece of shit. You know.
See,
you make them laugh.
I've got that going for me.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Not a total piece of shit.
Not a total piece of shit. Keep the dream alive. There it is. Thanks, bro. Appreciate you. Peace.
We've got Maceo, Roanoke, Virginia.
Maceo.
Hey, John. This is Maceo. Happy birthday, bro.
Thank you, Maceo.
My birthday also. Yeah.
All right.
You were born in '64, motherfucker. Just like me. You 56 years old today, bitch. Keep it real. But you still my boy.
All right.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah, you trying to lie to everybody, man. Yeah. You got that 64 out there. You are 56 years old today. Yeah. Keep it 100.
Keep all the way.
Wow.
All the way.
All the way.
All the way. All the way. You going to get white boy wasted tonight.
Yes. Yeah, what are you going to drink on? What are you going to drink? Whiskey, said? Or?
We've got some of that fancy whiskey that one of your guys dropped off. So I stole a bottle of that.
Okay.
Have some of that.
All right, that's what's up.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to drink some Elijah Craig tonight.
There you
I'm
go.
I'm going to toast to you and myself and my boy Daryl Barber. Today is his birthday also, so I'm going to toast to all my homies. Right.
There it is. Virgo season.
Nice.
Go ahead.
Yeah, Virgo season. But, bitch, you 56.
Like Maceo. Thanks.
He is. Look,
I'm not 56.
Your hair has been gray for fucking 20 years, man. You're fucking old as shit. You're fucking old.
Well, I'm not young necessarily. But
you can tell how old you are because you wear the clothes from the decade that you peaked. And that was like the fucking early 90s. All your shit's like big fucking baggy ass fucking weird Dockers.
It's comfortable. It's casual.
You look like you should be out in the fields fucking sharecropping or some shit like that, man. Who else we got?
David in Mississippi.
David.
What up with it, Jude?
Man, you got it. It's John's birthday. Go ahead.
What up with it, John? Happy birthday, man. Oh, no pussy ass get motherfucker. Old hairy palm having ass motherfucker. Old long chin. No pussy goddamn dick beating ass motherfucker out there.
Thanks,
happy
David.
Happy birthday, goddamn. See, Matthew. Cool ass motherfucker. Still can't get no goddamn pussy on your birthday, goddamn. Goddamn, John. Get you some pussy today, man. At least today, one out of 365 of them, John. You got to get one in, man. Get you one in, man.
When was the last time you had sex?
Oh, sex?
Me?
This motherfucker said sex. Yeah, motherfucker, sex. When was the last time you had sex?
It ain't for one goddamn kind.
Well, no, actual intercourse?
You mean like by myself or with someone else in the room?
Well, I had oral. There was a blowjob in there, maybe two.
All right.
See? But no, actual intercourse, we'd have to go back in time.
God damn it.
It's been over a year.
Was it the prostitute?
Damn, I'm going to start calling your ass Marty McFly. We got to go back in the goddamn time to find the last motherfucker you had sex with, John.
Thanks, David.
God damn.
You were coming in there. Wish me happy birthday. But,
he did.
Oh, that's right.
He did. He wished you happy birthday like seven times.
See if you can get old girl to go in the woods with you one more time. See if that'll work out one more time for you. Yeah, listen, I got cool outside. So, hell, you know what I'm saying? She might, goddamn it, you know, just drop something for you, man.
Hey,
it is.
She just might. But
last chick went in the woods. John didn't come back out.
Uh-huh. I'm very safe. I'm dangerous.
888-742-3345. We'll take a couple. There's no more calls. Nobody else wants to.
We're really fishing now. Yeah, it's a shame.
We'll take a couple more calls and then and go to music.
All right. I got Sal in Arizona.
Sal.
Yo, what's up, John? Happy birthday, bro. I just want to say I'm super proud of you. You've come a long way from being new on the show, fucking it up, sleeping on the couch, paying rent for that fucking slut bitch that you were with.
She's lovely.
Originally, so super proud of you, man. You've come a long way.
Thanks, Sal.
The show is fucking awesome, so I'm glad you're not sleeping on the couch anymore.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, it's funny. When you put it like that, you forget the growth that John has exhibited.
Boy, those were weird days back then.
Yeah, man, you're a real fucking loser.
Isn't there some value in not giving up and fighting through that?
Yeah, you got through it, man. It took me and all the callers to help push you along. God damn it.
I'm glad Sal's
would you like
got
to thank the callers? Would you like to thank the callers for calling you up and calling you faggots and bitches?
Yeah. And a loser.
Loser.
Dirtbag. Worthless.
Yeah.
So,
boot chin and Mac tonight and all that shit.
It toughens me up. So I appreciate it.
Getting you. Yeah. See?
Thanks, Sal.
See? It's a win-win. They give you a little something, you give them a little something. It's a beautiful thing. Let's end with some fire. Let's end with something fucking awesome.
All right, let's see. All right, let's go with D in Madison, Wisconsin.
D,
what's going on, Joe?
Man, I'm over here. We just celebrating John's birthday.
Yeah, I hear. I'm listening, man. And I want to wish John a happy B-Day, man. And I want to know, Joe, if he get enough money, Jonas Cash, I have to get him a hooker tonight.
I sent him enough for him to rent some pussy.
Really?
Oh, that's what I'm talking about. Born Day. And that's a true friend standing next to you, Jack, when he buy you some pussy, Jack. Real talk. That's a true friend.
Well, yep. There you go.
Maybe I could turn that around. Thank you, D. I appreciate it, man.
There it is.
And thank you, Jude, for providing the means to do that if necessary.
You're probably not gonna. I don't know.
If I have enough whiskey, who knows?
You're gonna just jerk off and fucking buy some more whiskey. Let's be real. Let's be real. We know where your priorities lie there, John.
Gotta keep it simple.
All right. Okay. So that was John. That was the John birthday break. Happy fucking birthday. Hope you have a great year. And you gonna call your shot for you calling your shot for next year? What do you want to do for next year?
Well, I mean, of course. Yeah. I'm just saying. Yeah. Well, Keenan rides me all the time. I got to start posting more. I mean, that's just a given. I got to do that.
All right, there it is.
And of course, the world needs another podcast, so maybe I'll do that. Who knows?
John is going to be more active on fucking Instagram. There you go. That's the shot he is calling. All right. We're going to play some music and come back. Let's go.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
Hey, you. How you doing out there? Yeah, you. I'm talking to you. You doing good? Well, that's fucking awesome. You don't need me. But if you're going through a thing right now, having a girl problems, guy problems, kid problems, parent problems, work problems, any type of friend problems, shit, I got you covered. I'm better than therapists because I don't charge. I don't got one of those fancy pants degrees either, but you know what? I've been practicing at life for quite some time now. And your friends are gonna lie to you, let's be real. They're not gonna tell you the truth because they wanna be able to drink with you later on in the week without it being weird. We're not getting drinks, so I'm gonna give it to you 100. I'm gonna tell you what the fuck is up. So what I need you to do is pick up the phone. Dial 888-742-3345, 888-742-3345, and talk to me. Tell me your problems. So what would you do? It's coming up next.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
It's like a ray of light beaming down knowledge from the heavens above.
What would you do? You need advice?
Call us up right now.
Now. 888-SHADE-45. What would you do?
SHADE-45.
Yo, here I am, here to help you. Your boy, Judy. Life coach extraordinaire. Call up right now, 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345. And I got your back. Who are we talking to?
Brandon in San Diego.
Brandon.
Yo, what's up? So, all right. So my girl, she's an escort, right? And then she said, I told her like, oh, when I start my career job, she has to cut it out. But she's making a lot of money. And then I won't get my career job until like another year. And she's making so much money. But then it gets to me because I'm not a pimp or nothing. So it's like, so I told her to stop. But she's paying the rent. I don't know what to do.
In your feelings, pimp.
Yeah, but I'm not a pimp, though.
Well, she's paying for you.
Not really.
Her sex work is paying you money, right?
Yeah.
So you're kind paying of for, pimp. Like, you can maybe, or you can call yourself a deadbeat, but doesn't pimp sound cooler?
Yeah, it does. But I make my own money, too.
All right. So, you're torn right now.
Yeah, it's like I wanted her to stop, but then she's bringing in money, like more than what I make. She's bringing in.
Does she want to stop?
Nah, she just like she got back on the saddle.
She just got back on the saddle.
Yeah, she was pregnant. She got pregnant. Well, I made her pregnant, and then like I paid for her surgery. She got skinny. Now she got like a fat ass. Now she like, all right, let me get some more money. And she's, it gets to me, man.
Yep. She's your bottom bitch. That's the mother of your child.
Well, I'm not really. Yeah.
She is fucking men for money, and you're getting some of that money.
Yeah.
You might not be good at pimping, but that's basically what you're doing. You're in your feelings, pimp. Was she a sex worker when you started fucking with her?
Yeah, she was a sex worker when I met her.
Oh, there you go.
But she was like here and there.
All right. Well, I would just kind of deal with this. It sounds like this is what the arrangement's been. I would keep this arrangement going, and then once you get your career, be like, all right, hang it up.
All right. That's what I wanted to hear.
I mean, yeah, I don't know what else to tell you. Like, but see, you got a kid to support now, and will you be able to support the child doing what you do?
My regular job right now, kinda, but then my career job, like, you don't gotta do shit. She can just stay home,
right?
Do nothing. But right now, she brings in like a couple five bands. So it's like, all
right. Yeah, that's helpful. All right, so there you go. There's your plan. When are you going to get your career?
Well, I took, like, my test for it, like, last week. But then I got to take, like, a physical test in October. And then my homie said it takes about another year for them to, like, go through the background shit.
Damn. So you got a year of fucking your heart, your little heart hurting off of this shit.
Yeah. But then again, COVID happened, so I think the process is going to go faster.
All right, there
you
go.
But then, you know, from time to time when she's making, like, a couple bands, like, I'd be like, oh, fuck, all these niggas are seeing her.
Yeah.
But then again, the money. I block it out for the money.
Well, just remember that everybody might have her pussy, but you got her heart. There, champ.
Hey.
There you go.
All right.
Just fucking deal with it. And does she know that she's gonna quit once you get the career, or is this just in your brain?
Yeah, I told her like, hey, we should like cut it out when I get my career, and then you ain't gotta worry about. You can go like on your side ventures, like you can do like your YouTube or whatever.
Are you getting pussy? Are you getting pussy on the side?
No, I'm not.
Why not?
Cause I don't know. Is that cheating?
She's fucking other guys.
But you're getting paid for it. Hey, no,
no, like, it doesn't matter. But like, shit.
Nah.
I don't know, man. I'd at least negotiated where I'm. Wait. It's an open relationship, and she's fucking tricking, and then you can go fucking get some pussy on the side. So you just, that might help you out too. But I honestly, I don't even want to plant that fucking seed in your head, because if you couldn't have came up with that one on your own, I don't think you're gonna be able to win that argument. It's just gonna make things fucking more complicated for you.
Oh, all right.
Yeah, don't even bring it up. Yeah, just enjoy what you got right there. Said, isn't that cheating? Bye.
Appreciate you.
You got it, man. Isn't that cheating? The fuck is she doing?
Did you ever date a hooker? Oh, well, I don't know about that. Could you marry a prostitute?
I know a prostitute that's gotten married and, like, changed her whole shit up. Like, changed her whole shit up. PTA mom, like head of the PTA, went from like high class prostitute to like straight up going to PTA meetings and selling cookies and shit. So that whole, you can't turn a hoe into a housewife. It's, you know, there's exceptions. There's exceptions to every rule. And her shit was like, she was doing it strictly for the cash, you know. She was a single mom. She needed to cake up quick. That's how she did it. That's how she fucking did it. And now she's living lovely. I think she married one of her tricks.
Oh, wow.
So, yeah, it was possible. Yeah. I'm an open-minded cat. I don't give a fuck about that shit. It all depends. 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345.
All right, let's go to Michael in the DMV.
Michael.
Yo, Jew, what's going on? Yo, first of all, happy birthday to John.
Thank you.
And second of all, so look, I'm supposed to get, like, 2 weeks ago, my boss told me I was supposed to get a promotion at work, and it's like a big promotion, like double the money I'm making now.
Wow.
And I don't know, he kind of just said, like, hey, like, this is the deal, like, you know, like internal, like, you know, you're more likely to get the job, obviously. And like recently in a meeting, I heard that they're looking, that department is looking at applications for people, and I hadn't heard shit about the job. And I'm not sure if I should like go and ask about it, because I don't want to be all like entitled, like, hey, remember that job you talked to me about? But like at the same time, like, you did talk to me about that. So what would you do?
I'd be assertive. I'd be like, hey, I'm just following up with you about the where are we at with that thing. I heard that there's you guys are looking at other people. What's going on? I don't think that's disrespectful.
Right.
And it's like shows that you got a bit of a fucking backbone. Nobody wants a bitch working for them, you know.
Yeah.
You don't got to, like, have an attitude with them or no shit like that. Like, bro, you told me this. You know what I mean? Just be like, yo, just I'm checking in on the job. You said it was mine. I heard you guys are looking at other people. Where are we at with this shit? What do I... And then when, right. when he listen to what he says, and then, you know, go from there. What do I got to do to fucking seal the deal? Or that's mine, be patient. Or they're going a different way. You know, you got to figure it out.
Yeah, I guess I'm just worried that they're going to be like, well, we're looking at somebody else, and you know, we were just talking or whatever. And then I don't want it to become like a point of contention in the, you know, like the employee boss relationship or whatever.
You ain't bring this shit up. He did.
True.
So fucking follow up with him.
Like, simple enough.
Yeah, just follow up. Be like, yo, dog, just following up, man. As per our last conversation, was it an email or anything like that, or you just said it to your face?
No, we had a phone call about it.
Yeah. Moving forward and shit like that, like, once you have, like, calls and stuff like, hey, it was good talking, write an email, be like, good talking to you on the phone about this, that, and the third, I'm up for it. You know, you get, make paper trails, everybody. Everybody, if you're in a corporate environment, make paper trails.
Well, he doesn't
have to keep his word, but at least it won't, like, if it doesn't go your way, it won't look like you're just sitting there tripping, you know?
Right.
So, make a paper trail. Talk to him or shoot him an email. Like, hey, as per our phone conversation, da da da, boop boop boop. Where are we at with the promotion? I heard that you're talking to other people. Am I still in the running? If not, how can I get back in? That type of deal. You might not even have to say that. If he tells you you're not in the running, that's when you hit him back with the how can I get back in, you know. But don't give him that out. Stay on him.
All right, man. Well, I appreciate it.
Yeah, hey, look. The worst that's going to happen is you're going to keep the position you have right now if you're respectful, you know?
Yeah, well, at least it's a job.
Yeah, like, yo, just be respectful. 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345.
Got Big Sam and Callie.
Big Sam, Callie, what up, though?
Hey.
What's your problem?
So, I run this big weed farm, and I'm having this problem because my employees, they think because it's weed, they should just be able to smoke weed all the time. Yeah, and they're at work, though.
Yeah. Yeah. I know that's the problem with, like, fucking... weed stores, weed farms, weed everything. It's the people that are working in the business. It sucks because you kind of got to know it. You kind of got to know the weed to be able to slang the weed, but you also, people do tend to work better sober, you know?
I mean, you got to smoke the weed to know how to grow the weed, too.
Yeah, I understand that, but like, yeah, so yeah, I don't know. You should talk to them and be like, look, man, y'all can't...
So I had this employee, though, right?
Okay.
So I'm like, hey, man, you know, I catch him smoking weed. He's like, you know, right, just going to take a break in his car at 9 a.m., you know, 9:30, comes back. He's all high as shit. And I'm like, hey, can't, you know, I can't have you be smoking weed just right at work like this. And he's like, you don't understand. This is my medicine. I'm like, oh, fuck, we got one of these. You know, it's a recreational weed farm. It's not a medical weed farm. Yeah. You know?
Right.
And so I'm just like, I don't know what I should do with them, you know?
He's got a medical card and all that shit. You can try to pull.
Yeah, but I mean, it's,
are you legal or not legal?
It's recreational. It's licensed legal farm.
Oh, for real?
Oh yeah. Like I get in a lot of trouble for them smoking weed at the company, but it's just like, I don't know whether to have a head of your hand with it or not.
I don't know the rules with this one, man. Like this one seems like weird law shit. Like I don't know, like if he's medically has a get out of jail free card for like I don't know. You should talk to somebody that knows the law on this, and then you can figure out how to handle it best.
Yeah,
because I don't know if he's got a medical card and he's allowed to smoke medically. Then,
I guess my thing isn't so much, you know, I could care less whether he's smoking weed. It's like, you know, or medicine, just not, you know, I mean, it's just more that, you know, if you're lazy at work because you're high, like that's a problem.
All right. Well, then cut his position.
Dude, I appreciate it.
Yeah. Fires us. Be like, hey, man, we have to cut back because of this, that, and the third. We were booming for a second off the COVID shit, slowing down. I'm going to have to cut you. Let him go. That easy.
Part of me wants to go to this next call, but I'm not 100%. He's hearing voices. Do you want to go down
Whoa.
That road?
All right, let's hear it. Hello?
This is John in Texas.
John in Texas.
Hello?
Yo.
What's up, man?
Shit,
I'm not hearing voices. It's that people could hear my thoughts because they put a transmitter in me. It sounds like bullshit, but it's the truth.
People can hear your thoughts because they put a transmitter in you?
Yeah, because at one point I was addicted to meth. I've been sober 5 years. And while I was in the hospital, they put a transmitter in me. For they will track if I'm going to try to attempt to commit suicide again. So
they got transmitters for that?
Yeah, they have transmitters too for you to internal transmitters for you to listen to music in your head. I've heard you talk about it.
Yeah, but like I don't know if that's a regular thing. You might need to talk to like a professional psychiatrist because that meth might have spun.
I've already done that. You know what they told me?
What'd they tell you?
That my case was too complicated.
They tell you that's fucked up. Here's the deal. I'm gonna be real with you. I think that meth spun you out of control, and you're not all the way right.
I know you're in California. You'll trip. It'll blow your fucking mind, bro. I'm a truck driver too. You know what I mean? I go state to state, and you know, I've learned from the 5 years of being sober to look by teaching myself, by going by people's reactions. Like I could transmit my thoughts, and I could think something or just some shit pops up in my head and they react to it. You know what I mean? And it sounds like all fucked up and shit, but it's not. You know, I have trained myself to pay attention to people's body language and verbal words as, you know,
right.
Like transmit these thoughts.
So like, I think that meth fucked you up, man. Like, to be all the way real with you. And I think you need to talk to somebody professional. Sounds like you're doing all right for yourself right now.
Don't do meth.
Yeah, they who, like, I don't even know who's hearing your thoughts. You know what I mean? Like, that's the thing about meth, man.
You don't really come. Well, you can. You can come back.
Can you?
I guess. I've seen it.
But like, once a motherfucker goes, they're gone.
Yeah, I've met some people who've done a lot of acid. They just seem a little different.
Yeah, a little. flicks her switch a little bit. Yeah, fucking, yeah, there it is. All right, give me a upbeat one to go into a song. Christ.
I knew that was a risk.
Whoa.
Let's see. Got Vic over in your Detroit.
Yo, Vic, what's up?
What up, though? What up, though, Drew? What up, though,
man? You good?
Yeah, man, I'm all right, man. I got some bullshit that's going on right now, man. Like, I'm going to start from the beginning, man. Like, a year ago, my neighbor, he's driving a truck, right? And we've been neighbors for about 3 years. And like I said, he drives a truck, and he comes over, and he asks for a little piece of our backyard so he could park his truck. We give it to him. It's just a little slant so he can, you know, make a gate and a little bit more room. All right. So we gave him that. And then literally a week ago, I'm mowing my grass, and I look up, and I can't move my lawnmower anymore because he's put a fence post on our lawn, and he's trying to, like, build some more shit.
Nah.
So I send him a heated text message. Nah. And, like, he gets all professional and shit. Like, you gave me this piece of land and blah, 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 blah. And me and my wife start flipping out, and we just don't know what to do now. So it's like,
nah, bro,
I don't know what,
like,
the fuck is going on.
You didn't sign anything. It's your land.
Yeah.
For real. Look, yeah, you didn't sign shit. It's your land. It's your land. Fuck his fence post. Take that shit up out of the fucking, like, if it goes to litigation, you win in this shit. Like, it's not his yard. You were letting him park his truck on
right.
Shit, dude. Fuck this guy. No.
So, exactly. That's where we're at. So I'm at the point right now where it's like, do we continue to talk to him and try and handle it civilly, or do we contact the city and, like, try and go, like, the legal route? I ain't trying to get lawyers and all this shit involved, because I don't know nothing about that. I don't know if I'm doing it right. But he's wrong as hell, and he's not responding to my texts now. So it's like, do I knock on his door? Do I, like, it's just getting weird. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah, like, I would talk to him face-to-face, be like, look, bro, we need to talk. Like, we need to talk. I was doing you a favor by letting you park on my thing. I'm not giving it to you. I'm letting you park on my grass.
Listen, bro, you don't even know how creepy this dude is. Like, the fence that he made and that he's trying to install is measured and cut out to our house. So he has been on the side of our house. He's measured it out perfectly. And this is all without any of our acknowledgement. Like, literally, I looked up, like, what the fuck? Like, it was lined up.
Like, is there anything on the ground right now?
Yeah, I
take
got
that shit out.
Anything, man. Like,
take it all out.
Yeah, it's just he ain't cement it in there. It's just down deep into the dirt, like killing me, bro.
I would take that out and be like, look, man, you can't park on my lawn no more. Find a new place for your truck. Find a new place for that shit and tell them face to face. That's text shit. Go knock on his door when you see his truck home. Be like, look, bro, you're not parking there no more. I try to be cool. You're putting a fence up on my fucking shit. It's not your land. It's my land. And now you don't get to use it. There you go. And then if you got to bring in the city, bring in the fucking city. But you can't have motherfuckers. He's gonna be in your crib next. He's gonna be moved in. You have his cousin staying at your house. Like, nah, man, fuck that shit. No. See, it's boundaries, man. You gotta have boundaries. Give somebody a little bit, they're gonna keep going and keep going and keep going. See how much they can get from you. It's crazy. Not everybody's like that, but some people are. So you gotta be aware. All right, let's play a song. Come back with more. What would you do?
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
Hey there. Having problems? Call up right now, 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345. It is What Would You Do? Who we got?
Taylor in South Bend, Indiana.
South Bend, Indiana. I've been there before. What up, Taylor?
What's up? So I got this girl. She's very manipulative and very, hypocritical. The Snapchat thing, like, you know how you get the message and you can't see it after it go away? And so yeah. I see all these guys in her inbox, and I'm like, well, what they say? And she feed me this line of, oh, they just said, hey, and this and that, but there's never no proof to what's
You got a kid
on.
With her?
Yeah, no kid with her.
Man, drop kick that bitch ASAP.
Drop. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking, because she always in my stuff, and I'm dude, like, dude. What?
No more talking.
No more talking.
No more. There ain't no discussions. No nothing. Power. You need to do the power play on this one.
So not even give her the option of, hey, we done
no.
with Snapchat.
No, it's dog. Done. No. Look, the Snapchat's just a symptom of her being a piece of shit. Your girl's a piece of shit. She'd be a piece of shit if there wasn't Snapchat or if there was a Snapchat. She'd find another way to be a piece of shit.
All right, yeah, that's true.
So,
that
like, fuck her.
Yeah,
like, pussy's right. Probably good and all that, but and like, look, just be like, look, I don't want to talk about it. Don't even get into why. You just be like, look, this is not working out for me. I wish you the best. Let's go our own way. I don't want to talk to you or nothing like that, and just keep it pushing. Because the last thing you want to do with a manipulative person like that, their number one thing is their mouthpiece, bro. So you outgunned. You know what I mean? Like,
right.
You bringing a knife to a gunfight. This bitch is, she's a professional at finessing. You sound right. like a good dude that wears your heart on your sleeve. Like, you got no chance. So you got to just, the only way you can do this one is to just be like, nah, it's done.
Yeah,
done.
I agree. I agree.
And that'll hurt her feelings too. So there you go. That's the power play.
Thanks, man.
I know you don't want to. I know your goal isn't to hurt her feelings, but it will. So there you go.
Yeah, better hers than mine.
Yep. You make the decision. You decide who gets dumped. Because all she's right, doing man, is telling you fuck you. Every time she does that shit, it's just a little baby fuck yous. And then you keep eating them fuck yous, and you start feeling like shit about yourself. You don't want to do that. You don't want to turn into a shell of a man that you once were. Because you have some manipulative ass chick fucking shitting on you and gaslighting you. Nah, man, fuck that. All right, who else we got?
Trey in New Hampshire.
Trey.
Hey, how you doing?
Give me the motherfucking gun, Trey. How you doing?
I'm good. How are you today, dude?
Awesome. What is your problem?
All right, so I got a fiance like a year in. I proposed to her, but we're 20 years into our relationship. So
Jesus.
I'm trying to figure out. I'm trying to figure out how I can make this work and give all I got to this female, because obviously I love her so much for 20 years. So, what's your advice?
What took you so long to fucking pop the question? 20 years.
Yeah, no, that's real. That's a very good question. And I think, you know, not to get into my whole past, but there's a lot going on, and I'm ready now. So her hesitation is legitimate.
All right, so wait, did you have commitment issues or
No. I mean, yes and no. You know, I'm the youngest of three sons, and I've been beat up my whole life. So I don't want to have control from anyone, right?
Is she controlling?
Yes and no. I'm going to say yes.
Why are you with her ass? Do you like to be controlled? Something in you must. That's what you recognize, huh? All you recognize is being controlled.
Okay. Yes.
So I guess, but you don't like it that much because you was with her for 20 years and you finally going around to getting married.
Yes.
You got kids with her? Or
no, not no kids, but I'm ready for everything. You know what I mean? I'm old and we're both old and we're ready for that.
Bro, I would like, honestly, I'd probably
give it to me.
I'm gonna give it to you straight. Look, bro, like, look, man. Here's the deal. Like, I would tell you to dump her and like work on yourself so that you don't like to be controlled. But like, hey, you got some bitch in you, man. So fucking.
That's okay, man. I appreciate that.
Yeah, you got some bitch in you, and it's not your fault that you got some bitch in you. I mean, it kind of is, but like, you know, you just were put in a situation where you getting controlled is something that is familiar to your brain. So of course that's what you're gonna attract in a woman, you know, through therapy and self work. One could get over that, but you're old. Okay. Man. I've been in therapy, just so you know.
Yeah, I've been in some therapy.
Clearly didn't work. You're still with some controlling ass bitch that you wouldn't marry.
Right, so marry her. Let me just like bring this back to a baseline. Like, I need to be controlled, and if this ain't the girl to control me, I need to find another girl or not.
I don't know, man. 20, like, what was it? 20 years.
Yeah, it's been, again, she's been stood by me through everything, man. I think you lose the job, lose the home, lose the car, everything. Like,
look,
she's been there for it.
Look, man, you ain't going to change, bro. Like, I hate to say it. It's hardwired in you. Yeah, so fucking.
All right, don't apologize. Dude, I appreciate this. This is what we're here for.
Yeah, lock it in. Yeah. You got a touch of bitch in you, man. Just fucking roll with it. Just fucking embrace it. Have fun. Have a good wedding. Jesus Christ. Yeah. Know thyself. All right. Who else we got?
Got Mike in Cleveland, Ohio.
Mike.
What's up, man?
Chilling, dog. What's your problem?
So I've been married freshly 2 years. And before I got married, I could get all the poo I wanted. But now I can't get no poo. It's like once or twice a month, if that.
Really? What? Have you spoke to her about it? What did she say?
You know, I hint here and there and everything, and she just be like, "Really?" And I'm like, "Yeah, really. I want to get nasty. What's up?" Yeah, it's bad.
So, have you said something like, "Hey, we used to sleep together. How often would y'all fuck? Like, three times, four times a week, some shit like that?"
Hell yeah, yep, exactly.
Be like, "Yo, we used to fuck three or four times a week, and now we're doing it twice a month. What happened?"
Right.
Find out what happened and be like, "How can we get back to that? Because that's what I was used to." And try to get back to that. And then if she's still being like that, I don't know. Get some pussy on the side, bro. Like, I hate to say that shit.
I'm trying to behave.
Or dropkick her ass, though. Do you got kids with her?
Yeah, I got one.
Fuck, man. Is she tired? Can you help out around the house at all, maybe?
Nah, I help around the house. I mean, she worked from home because of the COVID, but you guys driving her crazy. But other than that, she should be wanting some dick every other day.
Yeah.
That's what it used to be.
And when did this shit start? When did anything happen to make her not want to fuck with you like this, or
not at all? It just spontaneously just happened. I'm just like, geez, I'm about to get blue balls around this bitch. What the fuck?
Damn, dog. Yeah, that's fucked up. You need to talk to her, have a conversation, really let her know that this means a lot to you. And I mean, this is 2 years in and she cut that shit off. Like, you're going to be getting it once a year in a couple years, bro. So like,
right.
You better figure this shit out. You might want to get some couples counseling or something like that. Cause it sounds to me like she's shut off from you and I don't know why.
Gotcha.
Maybe try to pay more attention to her, pay attention to her cues. Listen to her. I don't know. Obviously, she's mad at you for some shit. Like, women just don't shut down out of nowhere, you know?
Right. Uh-huh.
So like, I don't know. It sounds like you need to do some more communicating.
Gotcha.
communicate. Not I want some this. Not, hey, I want some this. Be like, hey, what's up? I noticed that we haven't been doing this. How come? Is there anything you need more from me? Shit like that. You know, stuff, you know, try to don't make it a, don't be begging and don't accuse. Just have a fucking conversation. Try to talk to her about it so you can figure out what the fuck is going on. What's really going on.
Uh-huh. All right. Gotcha.
Good luck, man. Good luck. Jesus. Every other day to fucking twice a month in 2 years? It's a fucking nightmare. And you got a kid? Hope he figures it out. All right. Who else we got?
Jason in Gainesville, Florida.
Jason.
Yo.
What's happening with you, man?
Oh, man. Fucking fuck 2020. That's how I feel about it right now.
All right. So, yeah. But what's the problem?
Well, the problem is, man, I got an old lady. We barely kind of knew each other when we had a baby. I got a baby that's like a year old now. And she just started turning like into a raging alcoholic, man.
Damn.
Fucking, yeah, bro. And then my little sister passed. And going through all that with my little sister, fucking she just started like totally uncontrollable, bro. I had to take her down to the damn detox center and shit, bro. It's fucked up, man. And I'm
so all right. So your wife's in rehab?
No, she came out yesterday. She was in there for like 3 days, detox.
Maybe you could talk to her about rehab and try to move forward.
Yeah, I mean, obviously. Yeah, well,
she's got to want to do it. Shit. Yeah, she's got to want to do it. You can't make a.
God knows I tried, bro, but I got a kid with her. She's only a year old, and I can't fucking give her the time that she can. She's like a stay-at-home mom, bro.
Yeah, but she's a fucking drunk.
I just need her to
drunk.
Get her fucking. Exactly, bro. That's the fucking problem. That's
yeah, you got a drunk babysitter with your fucking kid. Where's your mom at?
My mom's in Vegas. Don't even fuck with her like that, bro. Yeah. So, and the sister was the godmother, and she passed.
So you don't have a lot of family to help you out with this shit. All right.
I mean, I got family, but not really that can handle it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. What about her? What about her family?
Alcoholics.
All of them? God. You didn't see the fucking writing on the wall? You didn't? You were like,
know what I'm saying? Yeah, shit. It, like I said, boom, just happened. Bow. Damn.
Yeah. You don't put your dick in crazy raw, man. Like, because now you got this.
Pretty much, man. I mean, now I got this, and I'm dealing with it. It's tough,
yeah,
man.
We'll deal with it. And I don't even know if rehab's going to work. Right now, I think you're in some damage control shit. Hopefully, like, look, everybody's been going crazy these past.
Yeah.
Like, just people are fucking. No one's. Everybody's worse. Everybody's at their worst right now. Well, a lot of people are at their worst right now. People are really fucking stressed out. So that's the only fucking upside. She might get a little bit more normal. I don't know if you're going to fucking cure her alcoholism. It sounds like it runs in the fucking fam, bro. But shit, try to stay patient and try to keep her sober at least while she's with the baby, while you're working. Nah. Once again, like, only she's, you, like, you can't make nobody change. She has to want to change. So good luck. And sorry about the loss of your sister too, man.
Shay's problem is not as complicated.
What's that?
Shay in Greensboro, North Carolina. Not as complicated.
Yeah, Jesus Christ, man.
Not as heavy.
Fucking. Yo. Shay,
you're killing me. I just talked to you a second ago. And of course. Oh, hang on a second. I know why. It was my fault. Sorry, Shay.
Shay.
Yes.
What's going on?
I have two boyfriends, one long distance, which okay. I have been seeing for 3 years. 3.5 years. Okay. One local, and I've been seeing him for 7 years.
All right.
And one comes with a lot of perks. The long distance boyfriend comes with a whole lot of perks. All the money, all the stability. And the local one, he doesn't have as much perks, but he's got a, the sex is absolutely wonderful. And I just need to know what I need to do. I'm confused.
Well, do you want to move to where your long distance boyfriend is?
No. Not at all.
Well, that's not sustainable. And neither one of them know about each other?
No. No, absolutely not. They're both military veterans. So right. You know, the PTSD thing.
Yeah. I mean, yeah. How long you, is this stressful for you to keep up?
Actually, no, because I live alone.
All right.
And you know, my long distance boyfriend, he comes to see me, or we'll go to one of his houses and visit. You know, my local boyfriend, I don't let him come to my house.
Well, you've been with
not
this cat for
he's doing some housework.
Wow. Well, sounds like you got it fucking under control. It's weird, but I gotta tell you though, where do you see yourself in fucking 5 years? Clearly you're not gonna settle down with a seven year guy. He can fuck, but you don't even let him come to the crib, and you're not gonna move for the fucking 3 year guy. So like what are you gonna do? You gonna just keep this up forever?
Well, no, I don't want to. Mm-hmm. And the long distance relationship, he does want to, you know, move things forward and, you know, things like that. But I'm just a little hesitant because I honestly don't know what he's doing either. You know, he could be doing the same thing I'm doing. So
you might just be projecting.
You think
just because you're a piece of shit doesn't mean he is.
Oh, dude, I'm a piece of shit. Okay.
Yeah, you a fucking piece of shit. That's all right. Own it. Fuck shit.
Well, you know, I was married for a very long time before I was, you know, in these relationships. And, you know, all my 20s, most of my 30s, I was married.
Right.
So now I feel like, okay, I'm going to do what I want to do and just, you know, have some fun, but it is becoming a little stressful.
Well, yeah, it's like, you know, going to the bar every weekend was fun, or all the time in my 20s was fun, but now it's like you outgrow these things. Like, I think this is going to stop when you outgrow it, but there's no long term. This isn't sustainable. You can't keep this shit up long term. Like, it's gonna
run its course.
Yeah, it's gonna run its course. And it sounds to me like you're not 100% on either one of these dudes. That's only because, you know, if you fuck somebody long enough, you just love them. It's fucking science. I can fuck anybody into loving me, you know? You just gotta fuck them enough. The oxytocin releases, and then now you, boom, it's love. It's like chemistry. It sucks, but that's the way it goes. Mm. Yeah. All right, so besides you not trusting the fucking long-distance dude, like, that's the one thing keeping you from him, or there's more shit?
It's a little bit more. All right. Very aggressive.
Very aggressive. Why don't you go ahead and fucking do this for a little bit, but know that you're going to have to duck out of this and then actually find somebody that you want to come over to your house and stay the night.
Excellent. Thank you. I'm going to take your advice.
Yeah, no doubt. I mean, 7 years. Like, all right, you know.
Yeah, I know. It's a long time.
So, 7 years and you're still not letting the motherfucker stay at your house? Clearly he's not the one.
Well, so he now, was in the beginning, but well, I stopped it when I started seeing my you know, my long distance guy.
All right, man. I'm gonna get going. All right, I said what I said. I'll do one more, and then we got some new shit we're doing. All right.
Let's go with Gigi in Minnesota.
Gigi.
Hey.
What's your problem, Gigi?
First, can I say happy birthday, John?
Thank you.
Get some pussy tonight. Do something.
We'll see.
But, so my problem is I've been talking to this dude for about a year and a half. And, he will not fuck me in a bed. He only wants to fuck in the car.
What? Does he have a house?
He has multiple places. So he is a drug dealer.
Okay.
And I do buy drugs off of him.
All right.
And, you know, he has multiple places. The first time that we ever hooked up, it was like at his grandmother's house or something like that. And, right. You know, it was just a late night hookup, whatever the fuck. It was on the couch. But that shit was bomb as fuck.
Mm-hmm.
He gives really, really good dick.
Okay.
And we had been, you know, meeting up in the car and everything. At one point for his birthday, I got us a hotel and I did up the whole room and everything to celebrate his birthday or whatever. And he didn't even show up. So I was like, okay, you know, you drug deal, I get it. You make moves and everything. Fuck you at the same time. But at the same time, you know, like, I'm not just going to drop him like that just because, one, he got some really good shit. And two, I try to give people multiple chances or at least a couple of chances.
What?
He.
Keep going. It got
to the point where he was. I'm sorry. It got to the point where he was. I even invited him to my house, to my own home. And I don't invite anybody to my house. I have issues
okay.
with, you know,
right,
people coming and stuff. And he didn't even show up for that. This is multiple times that I have provided
all right, so
a place.
All right, so what is he showing you?
That
you're like, that you're not a starter on his bench.
Mm-hmm. And that's what I asked him. I was like, if you got a main bitch, okay, that's one, you know, that's whatever. We're just fucking and stuff like that. But if I provide the place to come fuck, why aren't you coming? It's that simple. You just got to roll through. How hard is that?
Drug dealers are notoriously late for things. But he probably won't let you into his houses because he doesn't trust you.
Mm-hmm.
And he's probably seeing other women.
Mm-hmm.
And that's probably about as good as it's going to get for you, what you got going on right now. So.
Oh, that fucking sucks.
Yeah. I mean.
Yeah.
Like, he stood you up on his birthday. So that means he was somewhere else with people that
mm-hmm.
he valued more than you.
And yeah.
He's not letting you in his house, and he doesn't care to go to your house either. So he's without saying things, he's very clear about what he wants from you, and that's pussy and to sell you drugs.
Yeah, pussy and in the fucking car, which, oh my God, it's so old. It's so old.
Oh, there you go. There's I like the car fucking in the back seat. You can push your feet up against the side and get some leverage. But I understand how that would be grow tiresome in the back
yeah.
of the fucking. What's he drive?
Well, he's got a new car, but you know, mostly it's in my car, which actually is pretty roomy in the back.
Yeah,
so,
what is it?
Yeah. It's a Honda Pilot.
Yeah. Yeah, getting dick down in the Pilot. Come on. Say it out loud.
In the trunk,
I'm getting Yeah, I'm getting dicked down in a Pilot. Go ahead, just
I'm
say it out.
I'm getting dicked down in the Honda Pilot.
How does that make you feel? Not that good.
No, it doesn't. I can't even ride a motherfucker back here. Like, yeah,
there you go.
It's not good.
Stop. Keep getting your drugs from them. Stop fucking them. And if you can't do that, like if you still like find yourself fucking them, you got to find a new dealer.
Yeah, you know what I mean? You know, it'd be hard to find the really, really good shit out here, but yeah, you're right.
Trust, I know. Yeah. No, I mean, my ex cut my hair, like, it was a real tough one, because she gave good haircuts, I was like, if this doesn't work out, I'm going to need a new barber. It's going to be hard to find, and sure enough, it didn't.
Shit.
Yeah, so, yeah.
You got to go through two or three of them before you find a real, real good one, or somebody that's at least decent.
I shaved my head for a fucking year straight. I was just like, fuck it. But yeah, like, so that's what happens when you mix business with pleasure. Sometimes you get burnt.
Yeah.
Yeah, he don't want to fuck with you. I hate to say it, Gigi. He just don't want to fuck with you.
That sucks because that dick was so good and the drugs are really good. But yeah, you know, I'll take the drugs over the dick and hard dick any day. Yeah,
there it is. There it is. Yes. Yep. You can find. Yeah. What for a woman? I don't know what. Is it harder to find good drugs or good dick?
Good drugs. No. Good dick, because most of these motherfuckers out here.
They're not doing it.
Well, not in Minnesota.
not hitting the spots. All right. Well,
no, they don't even know where the G spot is. They don't know where GG spot is.
tell them about the Mamma Mia. All right. Well, keep your head up. I think you got a plan. And yeah, just cop from him. And then if he puts some moves on you, just be like, look, I started talking to somebody. It ain't you. Just say that. Be like, I started talking to somebody. Still want to buy drugs. And if he's really about his shit, he's not going to. He won't get mad. That's a nice lie. Sometimes it's okay to lie. That's a decent lie. Just be like, look, man, I'm talking to somebody. We can't fuck no more. But I do need a ball. So what's the ticket on it? Okay, we're doing something that we'd been talking about doing, and we're going to try it out today. We're doing a follow-up call. That's where I gave somebody some advice, and we're going to call them up and see if they listened to my advice and what happened. And this is with Josh, and he was asking me about manscaping and eating pussy. So don't go anywhere. It's what would you do? The follow up.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
All right. A little bit ago, my man Josh called up asking about manscaping and eating pussy. I gave him the best advice I could. What we're going to do is I'll play a bit of the original call, and then we're going to catch up with him to see how it went. Here's the call.
Hey, I just got a question about manscaping. The wife's getting a little tired of getting the pubes in her mouth and everything, so I was wondering if you could help me out with that.
You get yourself two sets of clippers, all right? You got your beard clippers, and you got your dick clippers. Use the same ones. Just
mark them separately.
Put a sticker on one for your dick or something like that. Or, like, if you're just disgusting, just use them both and then just hop in the shower. Wash the dick off your face. It's your dick, you know?
You use both, or you use
I got
separate?
Two. I got two, because I can afford it. But if you're on a budget, it's your dick, you know? Whatever. And you just hit it with a number two. Just hit it with a number two. Go all around that shit. And here's the other thing. It's going to make your dick look bigger.
I need that. Fuck, I can use that, dude.
This is the way I break it down. You ever see like a point guard? You ever see a point guard on a professional basketball team and he's standing around everybody? He looks really short, right?
Right.
It's because all that fucking, because compared to all the ball players, he is short. But then when you see him next to a regular person, the guy's like 6'3", 6'4". Just a tall dude.
Okay. You got any
Your dick is like a point guard, bro. All that fucking hair is making him look shorter.
Well, I need a center down there is what I need.
You do need a center. How long has your wife been sucking your dick and getting hair in her teeth?
It's probably about 7 years now.
You selfish motherfucker. 7 years?
Yeah. And I don't even eat that cat either, dude.
And you don't eat the pussy?
No, sir.
What's wrong with you, man?
Selfish.
She got a stinky pussy, or you just don't know what you're doing?
Man, I can't breathe out of my nose very well. And so I go down there to eat the pussy, and I start suffocating myself.
Breathe out of your mouth.
Man, I want you to put out a video or something. Show me how it's done.
I'm doing it right now.
Maybe I got too short of a tongue.
Do you hear the silence?
I hear it.
Contempt and disgust for you. You got a fucking afro dick. You don't fucking eat your girl's pussy. What's wrong with you, man?
You're right.
You know who's eating her pussy?
I'm trying to get better.
Who's eating her pussy? Her coworker at Chili's is.
Oh, man. Man, dude, I ain't even got a Chili's nearby. It's probably Applebee's.
Wherever the fuck she works at, her coworker's eating that pussy. That pussy's getting ate, dog. You think she hasn't had her pussy ate in 7 years? Yeah, right. You better handle that shit there, champ.
That's a good point.
Yeah.
I'm trying to get better. I'm trying to trim it up.
No, you're not.
Baby step.
No, you're not.
Baby step.
Fellas, let this man be a lesson to you. Don't take what you have for granted. Tighten up your fucking dick area. Nobody wants to, like, no chick wants to pull down your pants and have that shit look like Don King. Fucking non-pussy eating ass motherfucker. What's wrong with you? Shave your motherfucking dick and eat some goddamn pussy. Start slow on the clit and then kind of move the tempo up a little bit. Just don't get on the clit and be like, it's gonna blow it out.
That's actually what I try to do whenever I do try to do it.
Yeah, you don't know what you're doing. That's what it is. You don't know what you're doing. You're bad at it, so you don't do it.
You're right.
I just told you how to do it. Do it slow, get in the groove, and then go a little faster. Throw a finger up in there.
All right. I'll do it. I'll give it a shot.
You're welcome, Josh. I'm about to... I just saved your fucking marriage.
You might have.
All right, and we called Josh back a couple months later, see how his manscaping shit went, and let's hear.
Did you go get the clippers or nah?
Man, I did. I didn't put the number twos on. I was stupid. I just went bare.
Oh,
no guard on it.
Oh, then what happened?
And that's a little rough, man. Get the old ingrown hairs.
Yeah,
that wasn't a whole lot of fun. Not to mention, looks like I got a baby dick. I'm a big old fat guy, and I'm already a grower, so it wasn't a good look, man. I need to definitely hit it with the twos next time.
What did your girl think of you shaved all the way bald?
She agreed I looked like the world's largest fucking toddler. But you also gave me some advice on starting to eat that pussy, because I don't ever do it. And I make her give me blowjobs, and she gets pubes in her mouth, and so I felt bad for never eating her out. And so I have to talk with you, worried she was gonna leave me if I didn't start doing it. I looked up on YouTube, tried to get some advice, and there's some real shitty advice out there. I really need some techniques off of you.
So you are going down on your girl?
I am, but from the looks I'm getting, it's nothing too impressive.
I think you got to focus on the clit. You can start other places, but you got to end on the clitoris and start slow and then work your way up. Because if you just hit them,
flicking that thing.
Yeah, if you hit them like with that immediately, it's a shocker. They'll be like, "Whoa, what the fuck?" Like you overwhelm them. You got to build.
Okay.
You got to build up. Think of like a symphony orchestra. How you build up to the crescendo.
Crescendo.
Okay.
On that shit. So are you shaving your, it's been a while since you called in. Are you using a number two, or you just went fucking Chewbacca?
I haven't yet. I'm back Chewbacca. I'm going to do it again, though. I'm going to do it with the guard this time.
It's like I give people directions, and then they don't take it. And then they be like, it didn't work. That's you.
I'm not saying it didn't work. I mean, in the meantime, I ended up knocking her up, so.
Oh, there you go.
I already locked it down anyway, so.
Now she can't leave you. She's stuck with your ass.
That's the way to do it.
Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
You trapped her. you'll never have to shave again. You're fine.
Just see how far I can let it go.
Yeah. Have your beard looking like Jerry Garcia's face. Shit like that.
I'll send you a sweater next time I do it.
Eat the pussy slow then fast. And talk to her to be like, how's that feel? Not like after every lick. But just how's that feel? How do you like it? You gotta fucking communicate.
Hey, I just want you to know, people on YouTube are selling this advice and you're out here giving it for free, so.
I know. Well, you guys are paying fucking some monthly fee. It's the least I can do is help out with your love life.
Just to go to your vacation days.
Congrats, bro. And here, hit them with some nutting in these bitches. Here's a little song for you, buddy.
I've been waiting for this day.
And you did it.
I be nothing in these bitches.
With your toddler dick.
I be nothing in these bitches.
Don't matter.
I be nothing in these bitches.
Yep, 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 yep.
I ain't gonna pull out.
Why? All right, Josh, you did it, man. Thanks again for letting us follow up with you, dog.
No problem. Anytime, man.
All right, peace.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
All right, that was What Would You Do? You can follow at All Out Show on everything. At One More Jude on Instagram, that's me. And at Rude_Jude on Twitter. I see some of the tweets. I see some of them. Something wrong with that shit. And go to onemorejude.com if you want to grab yourself some All Out Show apparel. Proceeds go to fucking Kenan and John. Boom. Yeah. What we got? Some kinky sex dating site is telling you the top kinky COVID shit. Is that the right way to say it?
Sure.
Kinky as shit people are into right now during the COVID shutdown, what they're searching for and shit like that. Furbies isn't on there. That's the one thing I can tell you. Which I don't know about that. Like,
people dress up.
Just trying to get the nut out of the fucking fur. Like, that seems. Ugh.
Oh, it just seems terrible. Sweaty and smelly.
Yeah, it's real bad. Bad news. Anyway. So, yeah, that's what we got. That's what we got for you. So. Stay tuned. All Out Show. News is coming up next. Boom.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
And now, it's time for News from the Chin with John Z. Matthews.
There is this kink app.
Hey.
And it's pretty self-explanatory. If you're into kinks and rough sex and all that stuff, then you'd want to check them out. But they put together this survey here. Put together 10 sexual kinks that are now popping during the lockdown.
The popping kinks. Yeah. That's what people are looking for on the kink thing.
Well,
how many fucking people are on this site? Like,
well, they spoke to, looks like near 3,500.
Okay, all right, that's decent. That's a decent sample size. I hate when they're like, we talked to 100 people here at the top kinks in America.
Yeah.
All right, what is it?
All right, well, I mean, I could just start with number one, or you want me to go backwards?
Nah, go backwards, like the countdown.
All right, here we go. Voyeurism and sadism and masochism, obviously. I mean, I thought isn't that just like kink? I don't know.
It is like spanking and fucking getting tied up and whipped and shit.
Yeah. and All right. You've done it, but
yeah, well, I felt goofy doing it. I guess they didn't go hard enough. You know what I mean?
Oh yeah,
they took it easy on me. Like it didn't really hurt. It was just kind of like, all right. I ended up losing my watch. that was the one thing I remember from that. I had a really nice watch I lost doing that kink shit.
But these BDSM people always accuse me of being vanilla, which I call bullshit on. But, I mean, do you have to be into masochism not to be vanilla in their world? I mean, am I?
I don't know, man. I told you one of the first times I saw some shit like that. I was at, it was like Lower East Side in like 04, 05 or some shit. I was at some fucking weird, like, it was like a weird disco, like half disco, half goth, half fucking gay, half fucking hipster club. Like, it was just one of those weird mishmash clubs. I was like, there was this badass chick, but she was tall as fuck. I was like, damn, that chick is bad and she's tall as shit. I went over there to walk up and see what she was about, and she was just standing on a dude. Oh. Like, she was just standing on him. Everywhere she went, he would, like, follow her and then just lay down, and then she would stand on him again, and she was wearing high heels. That was his deal.
How does that happen to somebody? When do you realize that that's a good thing?
Yeah, when are you like, man, you know what I just want? I just want to fucking lay down in the most disgusting ass bar and have some bitch in heels fucking stand on me. I can't remember if he was on his back or on his fucking on his belly. I wish I could for y'all, but I just remember it was so jarring. I was just like, what the fuck? Yeah. Like, she's standing on a person? She's not that tall? Like,
I would just hit the door.
He's just really fat.
Did he have like a raging hard on or something? Or
I didn't see one. I wasn't like I didn't inspect. I didn't stare the motherfuckers down. I just looked over like hell, motherfucking no. She over there drinking fucking red wine and shit, standing on some fat businessman. Fucking weird.
Also,
you know that guy's got a wife and kids somewhere.
Role play. So I guess. I guess I'd fall into that category. Have somebody dress up like a teacher. I don't know.
Yeah, you like the role play shit.
Well, in theory. Never really done it in practice.
I've done it like twice, two or three times. And like one time it was hot, and then the other time you just feel real goofy.
Well, yeah, the problem that I would have is I'm not getting into character. I'd just be like, hey, you look pretty hot. And then...
You're not going to become like an Australian pimp. Hello. Hey, mate. Suck me dick. Suck me shrimp.
Couldn't do my homework last night. What's my punishment? And all that.
Yeah. See, yeah. Look, you want the mask. You see that it's in you. It's in you. Maybe we splurge and get you a fucking dom.
Oh, they're out there in the audience. They call up once in a while. They think I'm into it.
You are. You just said it. That was a Freudian slip, bro. You fucking just said what you wanted.
I don't know what you're talking about. Now, also, foot fetish. Those freaks.
My homie's got a foot fetish, and we're at this place, we're at the hookah place that I go to, and he started asking the waitress about her feet, and she won't wait on us anymore.
Oh, see?
I'm looking at him like, bro, dog, like, don't, like, this is not, and the worst part, he knew what he was doing, too. Like, he wasn't, like, some people are assholes and don't realize it. Like, he knew what the fuck he was doing. I'm looking at him like, bro, we got to come here, man. Like,
yeah,
don't ask her about her fucking feet. Ugh.
Oh, yeah, those women pick up on it instantly. I mean, you know, the guy I'm fighting in late October, Greg Fitzsimmons, he's got a foot fetish. So even he would just talk about how it's warm outside and women are wearing sandals. Like, Greg, what? So what?
But, I know, man. I know. I was fucking with this one white chick, and... a lot of times they're known for having dirty ass feet at the bottom of their feet and being dirty. And I can't get behind that. And she was like, it's funny that another guy I see loves that shit. I was like, oh. It's like, for me, I don't wash the bottoms of them shits. Where you fucking coming to my bed? Yeah. God damn it.
I guess there's toe sucking and all that stuff, but no thanks.
Yeah, I was just watching some show last night, and she was sucking the dude's toe. Oh. I'm like, you're three feet off.
Yeah. Almost there.
You're 3 feet too low. But chicks are sucking my fucking toe out. Like, what?
And also age play, which sounds weird. I don't know. I guess I don't even know what to make of that.
I don't know what that means. Yeah. What does that mean?
I would think that, I mean, I guess it could go as far as infantilizing
somebody. Yeah, is that where people dress up like little babies and shit like that?
Again.
Oh, man.
No,
that's number two? Damn.
No, it's not number two. We're in the middle of the list here.
Oh, fuck. Hey, Jesus, man.
And this is a big category, but anal play. Hey.
That don't count.
Yeah.
That's fucking... I think anal's vanilla now, dog. Like... Motherfuckers be butt-fucking on the first date now, you know? Like, it's not even that deep.
Yeah, for once, at some point, I'd rather have anal over vaginal first, but who knows? For no real reason, just to do it.
Just to get not.
I don't know.
There's one chick that I fucked in the ass and never got in the pussy. The one that got away. I still don't know what the fuck, what the inside of her fucking vagina feels like, but I sure did sodomize her.
And bondage. I guess. Yeah.
Doesn't that count? Isn't that S&M? Or is that like, no, I guess not.
So you need a whole kit, which I think you have at home, don't you? Some things like that.
Man, I just tie them up and shit. I don't.
You don't have a ball gag at your place?
Nah, I'm not like it. It's not that deep.
And then orgasm control.
Oh, there you go.
The edging. Also, we're getting close. Dom and sub. So when you're dominant versus a submissive guy, I guess.
That's redundant. All right, next.
And then finally, virtual sex. That is number one, which doesn't really sound like a kid.
Lame. Lame. Lame.
Well, in the past, COVID, how many people were doing
sex.
That? Yeah. I mean, that's why it's big now.
That's not even kinky, though. That's fucking safe. It's like bitch-ass sex. Like, if you really want to go for it, fucking have fucking regular sex where you might get a fucking disease. Oh, yeah.
Oh, that sounds kinky.
That's what I'm talking about.
Getting a disease.
The chick I slept with the other night, she just popped up over. She wouldn't kiss. I was like, all right, fuck it.
Oh, she did? She just said no?
She just kind of moved her head. Like, she was afraid of the COVID, I guess. It's like, all right, man. We're fucking, like, you know, I'm a foot apart pumping away. Like, whatever breathing and shit, that you know, whatever you got, I think I'm going to catch.
See, that would throw off my game pretty dramatically if somebody sort of moved away like that. That didn't. No.
Yeah, I mean, I understood. I mean, like, it wasn't all hurt. If it wasn't in the middle of fucking COVID season, maybe I'd be like, bitch, what the fuck is wrong with you? And I wouldn't call her a bitch to her face. I'd be like, dear, what's wrong with you? But in my head, I'd be like, bitch, for real? You want to fucking kiss me?
Well, I guess you will not be having much virtual sex in the future.
No. Nope, just real sex for me. I want that real sex. That fucking flesh. I'm going to do fucking jerk off into a camera so they can screenshot that shit.
Does not sound wise.
Yeah. Bad move.
Yeah, I'd wake up in the morning and be like, ah, fuck, that happened. So, we'll see. So the dark web, there was a huge bust. It was actually fairly substantial, and they're calling it an opioid bust, but they got a lot of drugs, a lot of money. A lot of people here in the U.S. got arrested, And they're saying 1,100 pounds of drugs, including fentanyl, oxycodone, heroin, coke, ecstasy, MDMA. But again, 1,100 pounds, is that a lot? It sounds like a lot.
Half a ton of drugs? Yeah. Was it all from like one person, or was it multiple people? Or?
Oh, they arrested a bunch. Looks like 121 people were picked up here in the U.S.,
damn.
42 in Germany, 8 in the Netherlands, 4 in the UK, and some other places. But, so the cops are saying the golden age of the dark web marketplace is over.
Could be shit. But you know what, man? Like, technology, like, criminals always have a way of, like, keeping one step ahead, you know? Like, they shut down Silk Road and this shit popped up again, you know?
Right. Oh, it's been going for years. That Silk Road thing is ancient history in my mind.
Yeah. Silk Road stopped years and years and years ago. And then people still kept doing it, just not at that level.
Well, this seems to be tied to, I'm sure there were other markets, but the one that they point to here is called Wall Street. And they took down Wall Street back in May of 2019. And I don't know what really went on, because they're not saying how they did this, but my guess is they squeezed some of the people that they caught and they turned on other people. That's just a guess.
They get the... I don't know. Yeah, I don't know how that shit works. Like, I don't... I feel like if... What is it? You got... It's Tor? Is that the name of the thing?
Yeah.
Like, I feel if I go on Tor, I'm just going to fucking... lose my identity. Someone's just gonna take all my shit, so I just stay away from it.
I still go down there once in a while.
I had a listener come by and show me how to set it up and the whole nine, and then I was just like, nah.
It's really easy now.
To you, because you're a fucking nerd. You're like a computer nerd. I'm not a computer nerd. I don't know how to do any of that shit. I hit the wrong button, I'll give somebody my whole fucking social security number or some shit.
I think the last time I went down there, I was looking for hitmen, not to kill somebody, but I saw these stories about hitmen. I was like, this is bullshit. There are no hitmen. And I'm sure they're out there, I guess, but that just seems like fantasy.
Yeah, there's certain shit I would just probably stay away from on that shit. Like human trafficking and hitmen. I would keep it, I'd just stay in the drug realm.
Good idea.
I wouldn't ask for lungs or nothing like that. I'd just keep it in the... In the drug realm, cause you know the feds on that bitch too, you know.
Oh, of course they are right now.
Yeah, they're on that shit.
Yeah. So don't think you're safe. You gotta take some precautions.
Yeah. Be careful. Be fucking careful.
Now Ford, they are supposedly about to find out whether the stick shift is worth saving.
I thought they already like engineered it where the cars can drive better without the stick. Because back in the day, the sports cars, like the stick performed better than the automatic, but I thought they've achieved it where the computer can make the cars go faster. This is just to have fun driving. Is that it?
It seems like that's what some people want. I mean, I would love to have a stick again.
Dog, I learned on the stick, but we only had, all my dad had was like this beat up ass Chevette with like a hole in the floor and shit, and that was it. That's all we had. And I just remember fucking, cause Michigan, they salt the fuck out of the roads, so it rots the bottoms of the cars out. And he just, like, any little mistake I was making, he was freaking the fuck out, cause that was our only car. So, like, I barely knew how to drive stick. And then the last time I tried to drive, my homeboy was drunk and I stalled out diagonal in the middle of 8 Mile at like 2 a.m. It's like, give me that shit. So, I might be able to drive a stick to get away right now if my life depended on it. I think I'd remember a bit, but man, it's been a long time.
Yeah. I mean, just ride the clutch a bit. I mean, don't wear it out, but if you're really in a panic, just ride the clutch more than you should. You should be able to start it up and get out of there.
Yeah, even if I got to go in first gear.
Yeah, exactly.
Actually, once you get in first gear, you're pretty much good.
Right.
It's just that good.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I don't see that much, but when I was growing up, I'd see it all the time. So I'm learning they're just bucking the car in the driveway.
When I went down to Peru, everybody, they didn't have any automatics. It was all manual. This was fucking, I don't know, 10 years ago, but sure. Everybody had manual. It was just, they were just whipping that bitch.
I can't remember. Is it more expensive to have an automatic? Or I can't, there was.
Yeah.
It is, okay.
Yeah, standards are, the stick shifts were the cheaper version, so.
Right.
I guess that would make sense why Peru would be all fucking stick shift.
Well, this is coming up because Ford, of course, the Bronco that we talked about a while back is now out. And then I guess with this one particular model with a Sasquatch package, it didn't have the stick shift. So people went to change.org and then had a petition. And for some reason, Ford respected that. And
hey.
So they're going to take care of them.
God, I hope so. I have bought stock in Ford after I saw that motherfucking Bronco. And then they redesigned it. And I was like, you bastards.
I think it looks pretty good, even the whole Sasquatch package.
Yeah, but like, man, the little demo one that they were like leaking a year ago, that bitch was hard, man. Hmm. It looked closer to the OJ than this one does. This one looks like a weird Jeep, but that's cool. Let's see it. Now I want to see if that shit fucking affected my goddamn thing.
Do you have a wide portfolio in stocks?
Diversified. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. And yo, remember that time that dude was like, buy this stock, it's gonna blow up.
I remember that.
I was like, yeah, I'll buy $500 worth of your shit.
That's right. What's the industry
it didn't
again?
Blow up.
It did or did it not?
No. It did not. Didn't make it.
I think the story was that they were releasing some sort of technology that week, and there was a spike, but it probably came back down to earth or something. No.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. Look into stocks, y'all. I'm a fucking idiot though when it comes to stocks, but whatever. All right, man.
When it comes to your insomnia. There's a chance that there's this, what they're calling ear zapper. It could help you out. It works by stimulating the release of the hormone melatonin.
Hey, so where do you get that from?
Well, they're developing it. I'll just keep an eye on it.
Fuck me.
But would you wear this device at night if it would help you?
Yeah. I wear a fucking furry outfit if that shit made me sleep good, bro. I wear a tutu if I can get some fucking sleep. It's like, let me put on my night tutu. Fucking knock out. I didn't sleep at all last night.
What? Really?
Yeah. Yep. Didn't sleep. No, did not get much sleep. So.
Do you just sit there and stare at the ceiling and curse your life or something? Or what?
Roll one way, then the other way, then if I can sit there and I breathe. I don't know. It's a whole ordeal.
And you could up your... I'm not saying do drugs, but you could get a real sleep aid, not the ones that you call sleep aids, but...
All the ones I have are sleep aids.
No.
Ford stock went down. Looks like they're not impressed by that stick shift fucking move. There you go.
All right, so seniors, the olds, they are now more mentally and physically fit than 30 years ago. So we're living longer and better.
Science, it's amazing. Well, back in the day, like the number one. The people that bought kale the most would be like Ponderosa or Sizzler or some shit like that. Because they would use kale to put around the fucking salad bar. And now like people eat it. And the whole food pyramid thing is kind of like a sham. People figured that out. Also, medicine. They've made leaps and bounds in medicine. Yeah. So, yeah.
I mean, everything, just the quality of life has gone up so much that, I mean, from education to jobs to money to everything.
Yeah. Yeah, cats are living longer. Cats are living longer.
Yeah, I think I just, with the whole Supreme Court thing, I think I read something about back when the Constitution was written, the life expectancy was, what, 50 years old? Can you imagine that? When you're, can you imagine dying at 50 and you're like an old person?
Is that how it goes, or is that like, do they average in baby deaths? Because that fucking, there's a ton of fucking baby deaths, and that fucks up the average.
It could be.
Because if someone dies at zero, you know. Got a lot of those going on. Might bring that, bring the average death fucking age down a bit.
If you were to guess, how long are you gonna be out here?
Fuck, I don't even know, bro.
Me neither. I don't know how long
I wanna be out here for, to be all the way real with you, man. Sometimes I'm like, yeah.
Enough of this.
Might as well keep going. Yeah, I know. Who knows? Yeah, I probably die in my fucking. I'm probably halfway there.
All right.
I probably got like 40 more years.
It's not bad.
Cause you think about with science and shit getting better, I'll just die at 80.
I could live with that, which is a dumb thing to say, but yeah, 80's not bad.
Yeah. Look, man, I just don't want to get to a point where someone else is wiping my ass or some shit like that. I want to be, you know what I mean? Like, I just, and I'm saying that right now. All of these discussions about death, when you're not that close to death, it's easy to say these things.
Right.
But then when you're like right around the corner from dying, you're like, wipe my ass. Bring that college drop, bring that high school dropout in here to wipe my ass for me. God damn it. Or my child. Fuck. But yeah.
Well, supposedly, as you get closer, though, your life will be better than it would have been years ago because society is taking care of you.
Yeah. And back in the day, too, man, like cats smoked more, they drank more, they did all that shit.
Oh, sure.
But let me ask you this. Do you think people enjoy life more? I feel like they have. I feel like them cats just, you know, they like drinking. Like they like having a couple drinks after work and smoking some cigarettes and shit. Doesn't that seem fucking nice? Now they go fucking walk up a hill or some shit.
Yeah. I mean,
if they got one.
Yeah. Indulging is nice within reason. I think I've gone a little too far now and again, so that's not as fun. But yeah, I would sort of miss these things.
Yeah, dude. Yeah, that's what I'm screaming. I quit smoking because of the show. I was losing my voice, but yeah, when I get older, shit, I think I'll start smoking again.
Yeah, that's a good plan.
Fuck it.
Pick the heroin habit. See what that's all about.
Hey, see what the big fuss is. What's the big fuss about this heroin? It's funny, I was packing and there was someone had sent me a book on like how to make fucking different shit out of poppy seeds and stuff. I'm gonna thumb through that once I get to Michigan.
You're gonna start growing poppies? In
who knows? I might start smoking opium. I can figure it out. Get a little opium den, like they had in the fucking olden days, where you just lay sideways, and motherfuckers come up and
that sounds
light you up.
Pretty dark.
Whatever.
I do some good news.
Not as dark as having someone wipe your ass for you. What's that?
That's true.
And now, time for good news.
I have Mackenzie Davis. She is a 911 dispatcher. Let's see. Daytona Beach. So she recently saved two lives in the span of an hour during a recent 12-hour shift. She's a young lady, 21.
All right.
She looks it. But the first call came in. There was a mother who was frantic that the kid was unconscious, and she had to administer CPR, save that kid, and then a wife called in about a husband who was unconscious in a pool, and then she walked that lady through CPR.
Damn.
Yeah, can you imagine that? I mean, that's hardcore. Oh,
that, I thought that's way better than what I thought. I thought she just was like, okay, help is on the way, but she actually like walked these motherfuckers through on how to fucking save somebody.
Yeah, I mean, she's 21 years old, and she looks like a kid. And then so these people call up, and they're freaking the fuck out, and she's able to calm them down and then help them save their loved ones. And that's pretty hardcore. That's very hardcore.
All right, well, that's fucking bananas. Hats off to her. Thanks for saving those lives. All right, that's the news.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
All right, that was the show. Once again, happy birthday to John Z. Matthews, the producer. Associate producer is Kanan. And our intern, who I think she just got her password to start doing some shit. Doing some more shit. Way to go, serious. Way to stay on top of things. Is Jade. My name is Jude Angelini. This is the All Out Show. You can go to onemorejude.com if you want any more information on me. And if you want information on the show, at All Out Show on everything. All right. Oh, yeah. Last but not least, if you're trying to get mixes or just stay updated on stuff that the show's doing or that I'm doing, lock this number, 213-205-3747. Type in pill mix if you want the mixes or just type hello or some shit like that if you want anything else. All right. Let's go. All right, that was the show. Once again, happy birthday to John Z. Matthews, the producer.